Tom, Bill, and I have been together for 15 years. They are my guys. They are part of my family. And Bill, Tom, and I have had many difficult discussions over the years, and I have never known them to lie to me. And it bothers me greatly that their reputations and integrity, and by association, that of our team, has been called into question this past week. I am confident that this investigation will uncover whatever the facts were that took place last Sunday and the science of how game balls react to changes in the environment.
Well, that was Robert Kraft right back before the New England Patriots faced off against the Seattle Seahawks and the Super Bowl, and you can see him adamantly saying that his team did not do anything to alter the balls. He believes Coe Harley and Bill Belichick and Tom Brady, and the facts will come out as they will once the investigation takes place. And we already know what the Welch Report has indicated. It's probably likely that Tom Brady knew something about the deflated balls. With that, I'd like to bring in Jake Plummer. You can find him on Twitter at Snake Steaks, former Arizona State standout and Denver Broncos. Jake, you know what? It's so much has been said about this. We had your fellow teammate Shannon Sharp on last week, and he was adamant about his disgrace about Tom Brady and the organization as a guy who touches the ball on every single play. Tell our listeners, what is it like in preparation for a game and taking those balls from the practice field to the game field?
Well, thanks for having me on the show today, Nick. It's always fun to catch up with you. And this whole thing going on with the balls and Brady, it's sad we're still talking about it here in May. The balls are important to a quarterback. It's our tool. As a carpenter has a hammer or a saw or one of his tools he uses every single day, no matter what, the football is our baby. We got to feel comfortable holding that thing. We got to feel comfortable with it in our hands, and what we do with it will directly correlate to whether we win or lose as a team. I mean, your defense can ball out and play really, really well, but if a QB doesn't take care of the ball and do his job, it's worthless. You don't get that win. So having a ball that you feel good, dropping back, holding, and delivering and throwing and everything, that's huge. And I'm a little baffled that there's a rule that limits the quarterbacks from conditioning and having a ball that feels good in their hands. I mean, the job that they have to do, it's an intense, very, very hard job to do. And I don't think that having the ball deflated at all, a little less, made Tom Brady's job any easier. I don't think it gave them any unfair advantage. I mean, it's a football. You still got to catch it. You still got to throw it. You still got to do all that stuff, breaking tackles and all that. It's just that there is a rule in place that he broke knowingly. And, I don't know if it's called cheating or maybe gaining that competitive edge. But whatever it was, he did break the rules, and punishment has been laid down, which I think is too harsh. But the football is really important. And I know that my playing days and back in Denver in 06 is when they first allowed us to condition our own footballs and, like, get them ready for the games when we go on the road. Other than that, we rip them right out of the plastic bag and start playing, and it was nerve-wracking to go up to the under center and have a ball that was slick and had that little sheen on it. I mean, that's why I lick my fingers to this day when I'm playing catch, even with my son. It's like I have this OCDC thing where I lick my fingers to make sure I have that stickiness and tackiness that gives me a reassurance that I'm going to be able to throw that ball where I need it. So, big issue going on. I feel bad that Tom's going to be suspended for 4 games. I think that's a little bit heavy of a price to pay.
We're talking to Jake Plummer, former Arizona State standout and Denver Broncos. Jake, let's back up for a second. You talked about a deflated ball. How difficult is it to throw a deflated ball down the field?
Well, deflated balls, if there's too much air let out of them, it's hard to throw. I mean, it's not fun to throw a flat ball. I like my balls to be a little bit, not deflated, but a little on the softer side. Not soft, like less of a rock. I mean, you playing ball, anybody out there that's played catch with a football, you get one of those brand new ones, catch the seams or the laces on an overinflated ball, it'll rip your hand apart. So, obviously, having a ball that you can sink your fingers into just a little bit just allows you to, like, have better control when you're dropping back. And me being a scrambler, you know, I wasn't tucking it three-point hold when I'm scrambling, breaking tackles. I was holding it in one hand and making guys, trying to get make guys miss. So to have a good, firm grip on the ball, you know, when the times you see a quarterback go and that ball comes flying out, that's because that thing is probably hard as a rock. It's not conditioned, and they don't have big hands or strong hands. And so it you know, it's important. And, you know, I did some stuff to some balls prior to games. I'd grab them and rub them in the grass because I'd just try to take off that little bit of a shine on it because, man, my job here was so stressful, and I didn't want to have to worry about the football being slick when I went out on the field. So the job of playing a quarterback is an extremely difficult job, and I think that the rule needs to go away. I would be full 100% behind that. If Tom went that route and tried to get all the QBs behind him, I think we should change that ridiculous rule and let the quarterbacks have the ball that feels good in their hands.
Jake, I just want to make sure that you're not altering any of the handballs that you play with because, you know, you're very talented. You and your brother are very, very talented handball players. I just want to make sure that you guys are playing the game the way that it's meant to be played. You know, you're not deflating those balls that you use or overinflating or whatever's going to give you an advantage. I just wanted to clear that up before we go any farther.
Listen, man, handball is a gladiator-esque kind of sport. It's mano a mano. You give me a wall and give me a ball, I don't care what that ball is, as long as it's got a chance to play some handball, I'm happy.
So you're saying, so here's my question now, you're saying that it was too much of a disciplinary action. If you were in charge, this was up to you. And when we had Shannon this, he said he would want Brady out 8 games, possibly more. If it was up to you and you had to hand out the punishment, what would it have been? Would you have taken away draft picks like they did? Would you have fined them? Would Brady even be suspended for a game? What's your take on that?
Well, I don't know. I don't like to play commissioner because that job is a tough job. But I just don't think that the crime that he committed, that they're saying is such a crime, I don't think that the punishment fits that. You know, to take away his livelihood and what he does, and not only that, but to take away and to punish a guy who has been very, very instrumental in the blossoming and obviously ever-expanding NFL across the globe to now a multi-billion dollar industry. I mean, Tom Brady has played a humongous part in that, and you're punishing him for doing his job and doing it at a high level. Whether the balls are deflated or not, he's doing it at a level very few guys can do it at. And I think there's probably, I can't say this, but I would venture to guess there could be some QBs around the league that are walking around with a little bit of a clenched up, a little worried, thinking, oh, man, what if they come check our balls, you know, because we're going to do whatever it takes as a competitor to get that competitive edge. And the fact that it is cheating, that they're calling it cheating, that's my point. It's like, this rule is ridiculous. Why are we being told, quarterbacks, guys trying to kill us, to tear us in half, why can't we have a football we feel good throwing? It's just an insane thing to comprehend that they're not allowing these guys that are the faces of their franchises to have a goddamn ball that feels good in their hands, whether it's at 11 PSI or like Aaron Rodgers, he likes it pumped up higher. Why can't he have it pumped up higher? It's a football, people. It still takes highly trained amount of skill to play the game. The ball isn't going to give you that much of an advantage.
Well, Jake, that was going to be my next question. With the rules being what they are, as far as no tampering, either taking air out or adding air in, there was something that came out on Deadspin magazine in January that it actually said, and Phil Sims said in the broadcast, that Aaron Rodgers said that he likes to put more air in the ball than is regulated. So if you're going to ridicule and punish and suspend Tom Brady 4 games, whether you believe in it or not, I think it's fair. But what's it happened to Aaron Rodgers, knowing as though he likes to put more air in the ball?
Well, nothing happens to him because I guess, you know, he's admitting that. And I think you bring up a great point, and something I've also thought and talked about a little bit is, like, when this first came out, there was the air of like, oh, what, don't know what you're talking about. What do you mean? And you know Nick and the equipment guys, those guys are your boys. I mean, especially me. I mean, they would have my Gatorade sitting right where I needed it. They had my stuff in my lockers. I didn't have to worry about it. I come on the sideline, I need this. Boom, it was there. I mean, they took care of me. So the whole thing from the get-go was handled incorrectly, I believe. Tom should have headed it off and said, this is how I like my balls. What's the big deal? And it could have been gone and a non-issue, I believe. But the way it played out, to claim I have nothing, what do you mean? I don't know what you're talking about. Now, an investigation has found that there was definitely tampering. And, you know, whether the ball boy just did a little bit too long of a, you know, hey, oh, damn, I went too far. I mean, I don't see what the big deal is, and I don't think that he should be punished like this. Now, Aaron Rodgers, if he likes him overinflated and he's saying he's been doing that, you know, if I was Tom, I'd be talking to every other quarterback in the league saying, yo, you guys, let's sign this thing and take this right to Goodell's office, and y'all come with me and say, don't find me, because we all take the balls and make them feel good in our hands, because I guarantee you that every quarterback in the league wants a ball that feels good in their hands, and they're going to do whatever they can to make that ball feel good. That's why the rule should be swept away. Get rid of the PSI rule and let these guys that are being paid millions of dollars to go out and do their job and entertain.
So, Jake, you're saying that the equipment managers, the ball boys, they were all your boys. You were really close with them. What would happen if you found out that they were, like, talking trash about you behind your back? Or do you think that was just from Brady being a jerk to them?
I don't know what that relationship is with Brady and his guys. I don't know Brady well enough to know how he treats people at a grocery store or, you know, anybody that's not in his circle. You know, I'm not sure. I don't know him well enough. But I know the equipment guys, especially the guys in Denver, they're still my boys. I mean, when I go to that building, I was out there just a while back, Chris Valenti, Chris, you know, he's the one who let me in the building, and I went into the equipment room first. I mean, those are the guys that to this day still take care of me, and they knew what I wanted, what I needed. They got it for me. There were times when I would scream at them, and where's my, you know, I'd be mad as hell because it's right in the heat of the moment, and my speakers in my helmet weren't working, and I got to get out and do my job. So, you know, there were times that it got hot and heated and words were exchanged, but we loved each other, man, and we respected each other. And I hope that they've never, you know, maybe they've said some bad words, but I know the relationship we have is good, and I don't know what Tom's is with those guys over there, and I'm sure this has put a lot of stress and strain on not only Tom, but also those guys that are just trying to earn a living. And I really hope that, you know, they don't get become the villains in this whole thing, because trust me, a football is a quarterback's best friend on the field. I mean, you want it to be the way you want it, and you tell the guys how you want it. So whether Tom steps up and admits it or not, I have a hard time believing that he didn't know this was going on.